Yo, what's up? Dr. Swole here, MD bodybuilder, back with another video in my 2020 contest prep series. Right now, I'm 22 weeks out, and as you know, this last week was a diet break and deload for me. So starting off with the deload, that went really well. I did everything according to plan, as I mentioned in my last video. To clarify, I kept my main strength builders, as in the squat, RDL, leg press. Those were the same, and everything else, I basically varied the exercises to give myself some variation. In terms of my diet break, I'd say the results were amazing. As I've been saying, a diet break is a period of about 7 days or longer when you bring your calories up to maintenance. The idea is that you reverse some of the negative systemic effects that you accumulate from dieting for a prolonged period of time. For me, this was manifesting itself in terms of low mood, low energy, difficulty concentrating, and food focus. Food focus happens when you've been in a deficit for a prolonged period of time, and you end up having these non-stop cravings all day long thinking about food. So by the end of this last dieting period, I was very food focused in that I was constantly thinking about what I was gonna be eating for my next meal, how I can make it tastier, that sort of thing, which is abnormal for me, and I would say unhealthy. So my goals for this diet break was to reverse those systemic effects and keep my weight steady. And I definitely achieved those things. The mood and energy levels came up right away within a few days. I think the food focus took a little bit longer. I think about 5 to 6 days before I stopped craving things. So I'll show you some of the things I was eating. When I'm going untracked at maintenance, I usually collapse my meal schedule to about 4 per day, which I find to be more convenient. And my weight stayed pretty much exactly the same, which I'm really happy about.
I started off at 155.8, and you can see I filled up about 1.4 pounds, which is likely glycogen. And then later in the week, I seemed to flatten out, which always happens to me during deloads. Anyways, I came out at 155.8, exactly where I was before.
This deload slash diet break approach does pose the risk of you losing muscle because you're not training as hard when you're deloading, or gaining fat because you're going off your diet. Now in prep, both of those things would be bad, but of the two, losing muscle would be worse because you can always lose a bit more fat afterwards, but muscle isn't going to come back easily. So I was aiming for my scale weight to stay steady, but if it came down to it, I would have rather it go a little bit up rather than down. Briefly, I was looking up shows, and my plan initially was to compete on April 18th at one of the WNBF shows, but there's actually gonna be a local show that's near me that's happening at the end of March, so I might be competing 3 weeks earlier than what I had originally planned. We'll see what happens, and this is an untested show, so it's not exactly my wheelhouse, but if I'm conditioned and ready early, I may as well jump in a show just to get my toes wet and see what the judges say. Now we'll talk about my body fat percentage, but right now I'm thinking that my stage weight is actually going to be around 145, contrary to what I had said earlier, 150.
All right, so here's my physique update. I'm looking pretty flat coming out of the deload as we just talked about, but other than that, not really anything new here. You can see that definition between the obliques and the lower abs. And on the back, you can see some striations in the traps here. And then when a bit of Terry is major as well, you can see my lat striations still there a little bit. And on this pose, you can see obliques that are mostly in now. So let's do a little bit more analysis here. I think I'm around 9 to 10% body fat right now, and I'm gonna walk you through my reasoning for how to determine body fat visually. When you're 12 to 15%, this is when most people start to get a six pack. And going down at 10 to 12%, you start to see obliques coming in. They usually start at the top. In the 8 to 10% range is when you start to see the lower obliques coming in. You also start to see some striations in the lats, as you can see a little bit here. At 7 to 8%, you should be seeing those lat striations more clearly, and you should also see more definition in the lower back area here. You should see the obliques fully in. So here you can still see a little bit of blurriness at my very lower obliques and sort of in that area around my lower abs. Lastly, at 5% body fat, you would see full separation in the hamstrings, striations in the glutes, and striations in this lower back area. That's how I determine body fat percentage visually. Let me know if you disagree.
That's all for now, guys. Thanks for watching. Make sure you subscribe, like the video, and comment below. Let me know what you think my body fat percentage is. See you next time.